NFA is very useful to capture from, you say, a very complicated regular expression. Regular expression building, a, you are giving a sentence that like, I want a language which starts with double one and anything in between. There should be odd number of ones and like this. This is the description of a language. You can make it. Now, from the, or any other description, say I have need a language where odd numbers are one and even number of zeros, like this. Okay. So, you can make a complicated English language and all these things. But this language to regular expression. Regular expression, then you have to simplify the regular expression by Arden's theorem. That regular expression, you like at a, at our, your beginning of the school, maybe 4, 5, 6, you know, some simplification. So, you have a expression, you have to simplify, say, generally the simplify becomes 1 or very integer answer, 0, 12, like this. So, same thing, by the understanding the language, you have to make it a regular expression. Regular expression can be shortened. Regular expression is not unique. Like, ultimately, any regular expression can be put into a DFA, and if, and the DFA state can be minimized and have to be minimized. Then if you have minimized a DFA, then all DFA will be the same. That means the DFA is unique. Okay, DFA is unique, that I want to say, but DFA will be unique at that time only when the DFA states are minimized. Minimization of DFA state is very interesting topic. Non-deterministic finite-rate automata cannot be realizable in hardware. Okay, it cannot be realizable hardware. So, non-deterministic finite automata is a tool to simplify to DFA. How? Like, whenever a, because you already know regular language, regular set, finite automata, non-deterministic finite automata, all are same. But language, you know, it's a sigma 0, 1 star, it must be subset of that. Okay, say if your alphabet is sigma, consists of terminal 0, 1, take the example, then all languages must be sigma star. But that I will not call language, because language, then it will accept everything. Okay, so that can be language, but generally we want some subset of language. The subset of language you have to capture, you have to capture by a DFA. If a language is captured by DFA, you can say it is a regular language. Okay, now this regular language can be expressed in English language, like I can express that I want a language where there should be only odd number of ones and even number of zeros, or I can have more restriction. It can be odd number of ones, zero, and this even number of zeros, and it must start with 101. Then I can more restriction. It must end with 011. Like, you can put lots of restrictions together, and you ask the designer to design a deterministic finite automata. So, whenever there are lots of restriction together, then it is difficult to design DFA at very first attempt. So what is the steps are there? First, we regular expression very easy with star, you know, if any number of occurrence star, and if zero number of occurrence, a star means zero time or any number of time. A3 is also a good expression, but ANBN is not regular expression, that I already cleared, because there should not be compared anything. Whenever there is a to the power n, b to the power n is not a regular language, because n has to be compared with the b to the power n, but a to the power m, b to the power n is a regular language, because there is no comparison between m and n. Okay, so you can, like these tools, you can capture the English language, and then it is called a regular expression. Now, regular expression have to be simplified by Arden's theorem and several tools. You can simplify regular expression comes. Okay. Now, simplified regular expression, you can directly go to DFA. No, there is no hard and fast rule, you have to go NDFA. But the good thing of NDFA is that you various restrictive clause of regular expression, you put it a DFA and you connect all these DFA by a new start state and go to epsilon transition. And at the end, you make a epsilon transition finish state. So you can make it very good design of NDFA that is basically a DFA but with epsilon transition at the start, so that you can make either or move. In the class like R plus S, R is a DFA which accepting language R, and S is another DFA which accepting language S, but R plus S means either R or S, and you can make it either R or S by a new start state through epsilon. But then whenever you make epsilon and new start state, that is NDFA. But NDFA to DFA, it is a proven algorithm. It is a proven algorithm. Now it is proved that you can make a DFA. Then after DFA is done, your job is not over. Then the DFA might have many states. You have to minimize your number of states. Then it must be unique. Then it is your hardware, which takes less number of transistors and all this. It doesn't heat up. So that is the, so DFA design is everywhere in there, in chip design or anything the DFA is designed. NDFA is required. NDFA is required for capturing a complicated regular expression to a DFA. Intermediate step is NDFA. Delta in the DFA is the transition function for each state and each possible alphabet, which state it can go. Only one state it can go. That is delta, and if you see the delta non-deterministic DFA, from each state it can go any number of states. That is, if the term, it should be, it can be maximum to 2 to the power q. So that is a power set. So the state concept in DFA and state concept of NDFA are different. NDFA is a combination of state. Then you can convert it to this state. The tuple concept is the same. In the DFA tuple and the 5 tuple, and you always say million more is a 6 tuple. So always you can remember that analogy, but they have extra output function other than this thing. They don't have accept reject in millimore. DFA is required. NDFA is required for for capturing from regular expression to DFA. Intermediate step is NDFA, which is solely on paper. Okay, solely on paper. No NDFA can be designed in hardware. It can be done. It is not that it can be done, but it is not useless because too much heat, because then so many states, so many circuits, so like non-deterministic, it can jump any place. So to capture in actual hardware, it's difficult. So NDFA is a theoretical mid step for converting regular expression. Regular expression has to be simplified by Arden's theorem or any other techniques. Then you can go directly to DFA, but you can go to NDFA and then DFA. So if any three state DFA can accept a language, the four state DFA can also accept a language. But if there are definitely some extra state in the four state DFA, so we have to minimize DFA. Then you will must come to the three state DFA. So DFA is unique. I should say minimized DFA is unique. Okay. So whichever is unique must be smaller in number, and many types of NDFA, and it is not unique. So by this logic, I wish to convey you. So all DFAs are NDFAs because DFA are unique. Which DFA are unique? Minimized DFA. Minimized DFA is unique for a regular language. How to get the minimized DFA? NDFA, to make a DFA, then minimize DFA. So DFA is unique, and whichever is unique, which must be lesser in numbers. NFA are two types. NFA with null moves, or some books say epsilon moves, or some books say lambda moves. All are same. So NFA are two types. What are the two types? With null moves and without null moves. Without null moves means from state A, there are two state A and say Q0 and Q1, from with 0 we can go to Q1 and Q2 both, which is not allowed in DFA. So with if you get 1, 0, you should go to only one state, Q0 to Q1 or Q0 to Q2, not 2. But NDFA can decide, I cannot go nowhere. I can go in Q0 only, I can go Q1 only, I can go Q2 only. Okay, this is NDFA without epsilon moves. And epsilon is dangerous. So your starting state is Q0 and you make a move epsilon or lambda or null transition Q0 to Q1 with a whatever you say lambda or epsilon or null, you can go Q0 to Q1 instantly. Instantly. No input signal is required. So that is great for capturing regular expression. You know, I have already simplified yesterday's class, last class, how to regular expression to DFA. So I took help of this blank or epsilon transition to put take a new start state, and all the DFA hardware R, S, and they are connected by plus. Plus means union. Means either of it. Okay, so make through the epsilon transition or lambda transition, or you say blank transition. So that is the requirement. So NDFA are two types, and NDFA with epsilon also have this kind of one. Another thing is, from once NDFA is only possible from Q0 to Q1, it can go through epsilon moves, but that should be labeled. If you Q0 to Q2, if it is not labeled epsilon, that is not permitted. So you can be Q0 then go to Q1 if it is a labeled transition. So this slide I have told you, this is, you know, again and again, this is non-regular language. Why non-regular language? Because this N and N, this is a non-regular language. Why? Because this N and N is same. If it is M or N or P, Q, then it is a regular language because there is no relation. But if we say P and Q, P must be greater than Q, then it is a non-regular. So whenever you put restrictions there, like here I put a restriction N must be same, or I write a MN, M must be greater than N. So I have to compare between M and N by through your stack, I have told. So, but regular languages are like this, any A start by regular expression. This is, you can find regular expression. These are the examples of regular expression. Zero or many occurrence, this is B0 any occurrence, but like this, this either A or. So there, you can be given an example. You are given regular expression. What are the languages? You have to write out the first languages. Today's topic is non-deterministic automata. This is my favorite diagram from Michael Sipse's book. I always repeat this because deterministic of automation, because one state to one state is only deterministic. There is no confusion. It can may go or may not go, but it depends on your delta. So you, if it is there, it go. It should go. It have to go. But in non-deterministic computation, there are several paths. If one path is successful, you can take it as a OR gate, kind of OR gate. So then you can say it is accepted. Okay, but if it is, so you have to try everyone. But the advantage of it, your number of state can be minimized, but actual implementation in hardware is too difficult. Okay, difference between NFA and DFA. In DFA, for a given state on a given input, we reach to deterministic and unique state. I have already mentioned. In NFA or NDFA, we may lead to more than one state for a given input. Even more than one state, even sometimes no state at all. So it can be no state, but that state, it, or it may be multiple state. Okay, empty string, that asks you question. Empty string can label transition, and we need to convert NFA to DFA for designing a compiler. Okay, that is required. For, you know, any compiler is nothing but it compiles your programming language. Programming language, take the example of Python stage, you have to get the tokens by the deterministic final state machine at the lexical analysis stage. Then the your push down automata for checking is the syntax analysis. That is the next stage. First stage is lexical analysis, and then comes the syntax analysis, then comes the semantic analysis. Okay, but we concentrate on the lexical analysis, where only FSM are used to catch your integer variable, floating, like any variable sorts, even the functions, whether the functions are global or not, everything is checked there and put into a particular table, which is that is called the symbol table. So everything is there. Okay, entry is every language has some, like a formal language, it has some production rules. So one language production rules, say Java language production rules and Python language production rules look similar, but they're different. So every language has unique, and there are rules like a formal language, like a same grammar, they have a production rules. That rules has to be different. So the parsing trees will be different. The parsing trees also, it should give a unique parsing tree. If it is not a unique parsing tree, then we call it the ambiguous grammar, which is absolutely no-no in our programming languages. So that is the reason we go for deterministic context-free grammar, and not all deterministic context-free grammar is programming friendly. So we are again a subset of, very subset of deterministic context-free grammar, which is not given unambiguous grammar. What is unambiguous grammar? Unambiguous grammar means like your double meaning word. So you can mean it differently. Like I have given, a boy is seeing the girl with a binocular. Where it is? A binocular, it is with boy or it is with the girl. So, but this inherent ambiguity in English language is okay, because your other-handed intelligent. We are, it is boy seeing the girl with a binocular. Okay, so but your computer is stupid. They cannot understand the double meaning thing. So that is the reason the rules of formal language will go to one and only one meaning. Then it is called unambiguous context-free grammar. And this unambiguous context-free grammar have to have conversational analysis that is done by deterministic finite state machine only, and parser is the other name is syntax analyzer that is done by pushdown automata. And this is a two different step. First stage is Lexer. This is Lexer, and this is done by deterministic finite state automation, and it checks all. It gets a token only. Whenever you are giving input a program, they sort out which are the variables, which is the integer variable, floating point variable, what are the function names, what are the keywords, what are the say Python keywords or Java keywords. So all this done and put to a table that is called the symbol table, and symbol table they are maintained at. That is access for subsequent stages. So this is a lexical analysis stage. Some books it is a scanner. So there are two names, lexical analysis, some books is a scanner. Then the next stage is the parsing operation is done, generally called the syntax analyzer. This parsing operation is done by the language rules, because your compiler knows you are using Python language and Python 3.9, and these are the rules. So if they violate, they get it out. So next stage is semantics analysis. Semantics analysis say whether you put some integer value into character value or all these things. These are checked in semantic analysis. Then the code generation, intermediate code generation. Then the later on code optimization and final code generation. These are the six and seven stages of compiler. A non-deterministic finite automata has the power to be several states at once. I have told each NFA accepts a language that is also accepted by some DFA. Okay, NFA can be converted to DFA. Yes, though non-deterministic is a feature which is normally not associated with real computers, it is an extension of the behavior of DFA. Okay, that I have told again and again. Moreover, non-deterministic finite is an essential feature of FA. Every NFA has equivalent to FA. See the alphabet only A, and this is tell me whether it is a DFA or NDFA. This is NDFA, because this is the initial start. With A, you can go Q1 and also Q3. This is not allowed in DFA. This is NDFA, but how you look at it? Because for a single symbol, A, you can be Q1 or you can be Q3. And here you go to a dead state. So this is a NDFA.
to let's the next slide. Two choices. Yes, two choices. I can make any choice. Here, no transition, no transition. It is a final state. See here, say this is a input string is coming. Your A comes, so you can go to here, and if you come here, you are dead. So not accepting this string. And if you go here, you can accept the string. So this path is okay. This path is not okay. So whenever you say this AA, whether it is accepted by this on non-deterministic final state machine, answer is yes, because one path. So that's it. So that is accepted. Accepted. Great. Second choice. So if it's second choice, it is not accepted. That I have told you. Okay. I have told you. Reject. But because one path is accepted, I'll say accept. NFA. NFA accepts a string if there is a computation of the MFA that accepts the string. Okay. Now A is accepted by NFA. Okay. That I have already told. Now this is the lambda transition. Some books say epsilon transition. Some books say blank transition. So here they use the lambda, because this lambda, epsilon are null, are same. So Q0 to Q1, Q1 to lambda Q1 and Q3, lambda transition. So it is. You can go lambda like this from Q1 to Q1. You just lambda. Let's see the any extension. See A. Okay. Yes. So that's it. Say accepted. Okay. Okay, another NFA example. How can it call it is a NFA? Because lambda is there. Whenever you see with A only one, but whenever you see lambda, it must be NFA. Okay, so let's see. A comes, it can go only this place, Q1, and yeah, it comes. Then B, it comes, accept. Another string. Say that is accept, AB, whether it is accepted or not. See here, QA, then B, then it jumps again blank here, and AB again. So it will be accepted. Let's see. Accepted. That's not accepted. It is in the middle of path. Not accepted. Now it's AB, part of the string accepted. But we do not say part of the string accepted. We have to push full string and then see what the status. Okay. Then there is no path from A and B here. So we choose here. We'll go. I can go without any input consumption. That is great. Without any input consumption, I can go to lambda transition. Another lambda transition. Now we go A and B. Great. It is accepted. So that is the advantage of putting the lambda transition.
Sir, yeah. in Q2 state,
yeah.
If we have done a loop of AB?
No, that is not your design. If you make a AB, here AB, then ABA will be accepted. ABA will not be accepted. I want the acceptance is AB only. Good question. If you put AB here, then AB, even a single A will be accepted. But my language is only AB like this. So that is not possible. Good question. I think I have answered it correctly.
Sir, another thing.
Okay.
Sir, if we give in Q2 state, if we give one loop of A and then from Q2 to Q1 again one lambda state, then?
Yeah, it can. See, NFA is not unique. You can try. I am not telling that this is the only solution. But you must check all options, okay? But if you make a lambda transition, it is easier to design sometimes. Okay, sometimes to get the you can make a DFA. You can I have given example as NFA. Definitely, whatever you said, it might be correct. But your first, that is wrong, that you have understood. And I have to check your second, but it is possible. Okay, Dibank, it is possible. There is definitely a DFA. There should be a definitely DFA. That we are going to do. Accept. So language, what is the language accepted? This is the NFA. This NFA language is AB, this leg, like AB plus. This language is called AB, not start, because you cannot go to final state with at least one AB. So that is the reason it is not star, it is plus, unary plus. Another NFA example, like this is the NFA, this is the start state. So even it, so blank epsilon is accepted because your initial state is accepted state. That means your lambda epsilon is accepted. So language is not shy. Shy means there is nothing in the language. Nobody, no string is accepted. But here, at least any string is accepted. Not any string, lambda is accepted. So language accepted like this. Okay, same like lambda like this. So this is the your accepting this thing. It is accepted 1 0 1 0 1 0. You can go to this is a NFA. This is looks like more a DFA. Then 0 and Q2. And say if any, say here, if you see correctly, say if after 1, 0, it should be, if any other, 1, 0, again 1, 0, if anything comes, 1, 0, 0, it go to a stage like Q2, which is trapped state. You call it trapped state. Trapped state means nothing, your future is bleak. You cannot be accepted anymore. So this is a trapped state. Okay, so you can go to step test by lambda also, like if it starts with 0, then it should be there. I think there should be one mark with here, so that means you are in trap state. But that is a lambda transition you can take, but this is a strictly 1 0 1 0 1 0 language. So 1 0 1 0 1 0 language, it just come another one, you go to Q2 and you are gone. It will not be accepted. So this is a NFA. This thing, let's see the next. So the same formal definition NFA as same as DFA. Only thing, this I think more or less same. Transition functions are all, it has to be tried with all possibles of alphabets. Yeah, transition of delta like Q0 1 Q1. See here, say with one, this is a, and this, what is this final state? This is a definite NDFA. Because why? Because lambda is there, and yeah, that is the lambda is there. Only for reason it is a NFA. Then Q0 to 1, say Q0 to 1, you go to, so Q0 1, then Q1, okay, and you can go to 0 1 here and lambda. So Q0 to 1, you can reach only Q1, nothing else. You can, and also Q2 also. Let's see, next slide. Yeah, Q1 to 0, Q1 to 0, you can go to Q0 and Q2. So it is a, this transition function is a set function that I told in NDFA. It is a different state. It is a combination of state. So with 0, you can go to Q0 or Q2. So this is it. So a set of Q0 and Q2. It's a Q0 lambda. If you say lambda, you can go to Q0 to lambda. You can go to Q0 itself. You can be there. There is an option, or you can go to Q2. So if you write only Q2, that will be mistake, because with a lambda, you can say, no, I'm not going to Q2. I'm staying Q0. So this is the your transition function of Q0 lambda or epsilon like this. Q2 1, that is great. Q2, whenever you Q2 reach here, if you put 1, you are now shy. You are not going to anywhere. That is a trap state I mentioned. This is a shy. Because that is a shy. Extended transition function, I think.
Sir, how can we replace epsilon in DFA?
I'll cover in the next class. What we'll see, the first step is, you have to make a whenever you get a NDFA, you have to make your power set combination. So you have to take, if epsilon is there, you have to take that set and make a set of set, and remove epsilon first and make your transition function table, that is delta table. If is DFA consists of states like Q0, Q1, Q2. Your NDFA consists of states like Q0, Q1, Q2. And your DFA, your transit states will be within second bracket Q0, Q1, within second bracket Q0. That is, within second bracket Q0 is different from Q0 in NDFA. And if it's any possible, like I can jump Q0, Q1, Q2, then it will be opening second bracket Q0, Q1, Q2. So that is a totally different state. So then we'll convert this state and transition function. And if it's epsilon is there, if you say epsilon is there, so you have to, through epsilon, which of the states are reachable, you put into this delta. Then forget about it. So if epsilon is, say here, epsilon is Q3, Q0, is epsilon. So from Q3 with symbol, I can go. So I had put only through epsilon, that is called epsilon in, epsilon closure. That operation called epsilon closure. If any NDFA diagram, if you see the lambda or epsilon, then you have to take closure operation. Man, through epsilon, repeated epsilon, where you can jumps. If all you jumps, the states have to be included in your transition function. Then you can forget. Then after the delta function is there, then you generate new state. So Q, say within second bracket Q0 and within second bracket Q0, Q1, within second bracket Q0, Q1, Q2, within second bracket Q1, Q2, all are different state. We can label it capital Q1, capital Q2, capital Q3, capital Q4. Think examples. At least, so epsilon, we first you practice NDFA without epsilon transition, then epsilon transition only at complexities, epsilon closure operation you have to take. So you have to add that state which is reachable by epsilon. Then whenever you make a delta transition function, then if you see the now the states are available, then they rename the state with capital Q1, capital Q2. These states are different from NDFA states. So a total different DFA will be there, which is set of state. NDFA is nothing but set of states. Then whenever design NDFA, you have to go reversely. Yeah. But if you see with you transition, say Q0, Q1, and in another you say Q0, Q1, that is the same state, you can refer it capital Q01, subscript 01. That is a single state in DFA, but for your quick absorption, you can write it capital Q subscript 01, or you can write it capital Q1, okay, as per your understanding. But this is a different state than Q0, Q1 in NDFA. Yeah, you should take rest. Your next class is from 11 o'clock, no? Okay. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.